Significant TV, significant stories, significant entrepreneurs. I'm your host, Fran McNeil, and joining me in the studio today is Katie O'Neill, founder and co-founder of Mushmina, and she is here with us today. Katie, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Oh, sure. It's so exciting. I mean, you are literally right down the street.
Yes.
And now you're in everyone's homes because you're on Significant TV.
Yes.
Very, very exciting.
Hello, neighbors.
Right. And before we get started, I want to, number one, say you look gorgeous.
Thank you.
And number
you,
two,
too.
Wonderful accessories. So
thank you.
Tell me a little bit about the accessories, because that kind of leads into part of your story.
Yeah. So Mushmina is actually a unique fashion accessory brand, and we work with artisans in Morocco to employ and empower and also promote traditional craft. Mm-hmm. So my sister and I custom design the accessories, and we use traditional techniques to promote the crafts of Morocco and the culture.
Wow.
Yeah.
Your necklace is very unique.
Thank you.
I see the U-shape. Is that turquoise in the center?
Yeah, so this is actually called the Fresha, which means butterfly in Arabic.
Mm.
And The patterns on this are to represent a lot of the traditional designs that you can see in Moroccan craft, and the swirls remind me a lot of the wrought iron that is abundant and beautiful across the country, as well as the etched detail, which is usually a symbol in nature. It might be an olive grove or, you know, the sun. Mm. So, yeah.
Wow, very beautiful.
Yeah, a lot involved in one piece of jewelry.
Yes, which is, I mean, jewelry represents the person and it represents the place.
Absolutely.
Where all of the materials come from.
Right, and that's very much what we are about at Mushmina. Mm-hmm. Is, you know, trying to promote that it's not just a piece of jewelry, that it is handmade and it has integrity and soul and a story to it, and mm-hmm. that's what makes it exciting and special.
Well, it's perfect, because Significant TV is all about the story, and I'm hoping that you'll share the significant story that brought you to being an entrepreneur.
Yeah, so I'm actually a graduate from University of the Arts right here in Philadelphia, and I have a degree in crafts. I studied jewelry and textile design, and upon graduating, I took a cultural anthropology course through Drew University to Mali in West Africa. And I would say that's definitely where I had my first aha moment. I had worked in the fashion industry for several years. I'm from New Jersey. I worked there. I worked in New York City for a large fashion brand, and then moved back here to Philadelphia. But I think it was being, after studying traditional techniques of jewelry design, textile design, and then traveling to a country in West Africa where they're using very rustic techniques, and it comes from, you know, a very deep-rooted tradition and a story behind the designs. And to me, that cultural anthropology course really tied in what makes those crafts valuable to me, and that there is a story inherent in every piece, and just their ability to be so resourceful and make something beautiful with what they have available to them.
Right. With what they have available, the beauty of nature and art coming together. What a wonderful way for school to literally open doors to the world.
Yeah.
So there you were in West Africa, bringing school and art and design together. Where did you go next?
So at the same time that I was actually in Mali, my sister was a Peace Corps volunteer in Morocco. So after spending a month in Mali, I went and stayed with her in Morocco for a month and got to just follow her around and see what Peace Corps experience was all about. She was sent there as a small business advisor, and she was working in a very small rural country town with a group of women weavers. And I was just thrilled after having had this experience and graduating and learning a lot of, hand loom techniques, and then seeing this actually being done on vertical looms made out of, you know, pieces of branches on the roofs of these women's homes. And I was just so moved, and I said to my sister, you know, wouldn't it be great to do product development with these women so that we could come up with something that we could share with the Western market and really the global market that represents what they do in a way that people can relate to. So we started to create handbags. So essentially it was a smaller version of the carpets that they weave. And because of the perceived value and because we kept the symbolism in, you know, in these bags, it was less time and materials for them, but, you know, a way for us to tell their stories here.
Wow. Can you... Is that represented here in this bag that you brought with you?
Yes.
Okay. So, well, tell us a little bit more.
So this bag was also an aha moment. So we've been working in Morocco for 7 years. And one of the things that I'm so impressed and moved by with the artisans there is not only their spirit, but their resourcefulness, which I think the rest of the world should take a cue from. So, you know, they figure out ways to use what's available to create these beautiful works of art. And often it's a slow process. And so, you know, I said, let's look around and see what's available here that we can use to create a product that would tell the story of Morocco. And this is kind of a, you know, a different take. This is Mushmina's interpretation of of the designs there. So in Morocco, they're not very materialistic. And in their homes, they have, their living room is called the salon. They have these ponges, these couches that line the walls. And really it's the richness of the patterns, the textiles that that they're proud of, that represents their culture. And so they're covered in these upholstery fabrics. And this is also the center of the home where, you know, friends and family gather and where they eat and share these delicious, amazing Moroccan meals. And so there's these stores that sell these upholstery fabrics. And I said, wouldn't it be great to create a product with these upholstery fabrics, because it's kind of an unsuspecting way to tell the story of what happens inside a home that's very personal. So this was one of our very first handbags. I sewed the first sample in my parents' basement when we first started.
That's great. That's great.
Yeah, and I literally came out of the basement and said, this is going to be the bag. This is going to be the, you know, the thing that, that people recognize. And we recently got an order from QVC.
Wow, congratulations.
So, yeah.
QVC,
you.
That's big time.
Yeah, we're excited.
Well, hold this up to the camera. Hold your bag up to the camera so folks can see. Beautiful colors, aquas and browns and golds.
We have since found a textile mill, and now we actually hand draw the textiles so that they're our own unique designs for the handbags.
Excellent. Wow. So that is definitely a significant story towards entrepreneurship. And isn't it interesting that your sister was in a place and had skills that the two of you could work together? That was then. What about now? Are you two working, still working together?
Yeah. So,
and how does that work?
Since
she's in Morocco and you're in Wayne.
Philadelphia, Philadelphia and Wayne. It works out really great. My sister and I have always been best friends, and we feel like we've always had such a special relationship. So, you know, it wasn't a total surprise to us that we would be working together. I feel like ever since we were little kids, we were coming up with, you know, new designs and new ideas, and so it just was very natural that my sister was interested in development, and I was interested in craft and celebrating cultures and, you know, in these developing countries. So, yeah, and she still lives in Morocco full-time, so my sister is our product manager, and, you know, we go back and forth, and we work together, and we now have a store right up the street in Wayne.
Where in Wayne? Tell us where.
So we're at 164 East Lancaster Avenue, so right on Route 30 here in the center of Wayne.
Terrific. And if someone is watching and they won't be able to drive by and pick up something personally from the store, how can they find you on the web?
Oh, you can find us at www.mushmina.com.
Okay, so that's M-U-S-H, like mush, and then Mina, M-I-N-A.
Yes.
Right, mushmina.com. How did you come up with that name?
So Mushmina is actually a nickname my sister called me growing up. It has nothing to do with my
name's
Katie.
Okay, I just wanted to check. I'm trying to follow along.
Yeah. So, you know, it's kind of like our made-up word for endearing sister. And when we started in Morocco, we were working with women, and we still work with women, and a big part of our mission is to empower and employ women in developing countries. So we felt like, you know, women have nicknames for their sisters and daughters and friends, and so we felt like it was a really personal way to, you know, to come up with a name for our business.
Tell me a little bit more about this mission, this inclusive mission around helping other women.
So, you know, in developing countries, I feel like they still have a ways to go with women just having more opportunity, really. Financial freedom, the ability to, you know, get a job and choose more of what they want for their own lives. A lot of women in Morocco in particular, they go to these netties when they're young and they learn these traditional crafts, and then often when they get older, there's really not an outlet to make money to continue to do this.
What's a netty? I'm going to interrupt.
A netty is like it's like a small workspace. And often these women might join cooperatives or associations. But it's like a small school where they learn how to make these artisan crafts from their culture, and often they're also taught from their mothers. And they're really beautiful designs, and you know, then they may not find an outlet for them to make money or continue to work on them. So, you know, we wanted to not only promote their craft and keep it alive, because it is an important part of their story and a great way to create relationships across cultures by telling that story, but also the women are able to pick up work from us, take it home, work on it at home, and it also helps create some financial independence for them.
I wondered about that, you know, in terms of significant business results, not only for your company and advances like QVC, but a significant business result for a woman in Morocco. What might that look like?
So some of the women that we work with today are actually women that my sister worked with in Peace Corps 12 years ago. That were a part of that very first project where we made the handbags out of carpets. So, you know, we've seen them grow up. We've seen them get married. One of the women we work with, Halima, now has three children. And, you know, we often ask them, like, how does this help you? I feel like statistically also women, when they are able to make their own financial income, they reinvest it into their family and their communities, which is also a really important reason why we're trying to empower and employ the women. They invested in their children's education so that they have more opportunities that maybe they didn't have growing up.
Very powerful.
Thank you.
Katie, we're almost out of time, and I do want to make sure that folks know how to get in touch with you again. And I wanted you to share maybe the story behind those two bracelets as well.
Sure. So
I'm going to hold them up, sort of, right? Yeah. Okay.
So this bracelet here was actually one of the first bracelets I made in my metalsmithing class at University of the Arts.
Oh my goodness!
And
many years old is this?
Well, so this one, so I made the original, and then I brought it to Morocco, and we work with a metalsmith in the south of Morocco who makes these for us, and he kind of gives everything his own spin. So it's really a collaborative effort.
Nice.
But it was made from one small ingot of metal, and then it's just about the way that it's hammered. So to create the shape, and that's what we love about it. It's just about the process, really. And then this one here is a newer version of our bangles, and this was also created by this artisan we've been working with for 7 years in the South, has now expanded his workshop, and we're able to give him several orders. He also does our hoop earrings.
Pull your hair back so we can see the hoop earrings.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent. Okay, good.
Our crescent hoop in medium silver. And they are, we call them malums, which means master worker. And they're really experts at this beautiful etch work. So this bangle here has all this etching on it.
I see it.
A lot of the symbolism comes from, you know, the moon, the stars, the olive groves, a lot of nature is represented in the work that they do.
Well, Katie, thank you so much for being on Significant
TV.
A great story. Congratulations on being on QVC, and congratulations for literally connecting the world.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Significant stories, significant entrepreneurs. It's right here in Wayne and across the world.